Hello people, my name is Ferdy and I want to learn from the best when it comes to marketing. So there's a company, it's called Apple, apple.com, and they have a website and I think they're doing a great job as a company. So if I want to learn things about marketing, I can learn from them. So let's take a look at their website. I have a website over here, really big hero with two options. You can buy something or you can learn more. What else do I see? They have a shallow header over here with our logo, a long menu, a search icon, and you can put things in your shopping cart. And when you scroll down, everything looks amazing. But what I see in the header is that you can see truth. There's some blurriness over there. So there's a multi-billion dollar company with a website with a blurry background that says something. What it says is that they're doing this, probably not because they're losing a lot of money on it, not because it's fancy. Probably this is working. So I'll show you in this tutorial how you can create the same thing using Elementor Pro. If you don't have Elementor Pro, you want to learn more about it, you can go to ferdy.com, hit enter, and you can click over here and search for Elementor Pro. And I have an in-depth tutorial about it and even a 10-hour course on the internet on how to work with Elementor Pro. So I assume you already have Elementor Pro. I have a website over here. It's really ugly. It is using Elementor Pro. So let me show you how you can create this in Elementor Pro. So I just grab those few images and put them in the background using Elementor. And if you want to learn how to do that, I have a tool. It's called Go Full Page. It's a Chrome extension. And I have a tool called SVG Grabber. And I can use that to grab all the logos from this website. If I go to this tool, Go Full Page. I can download this whole website as a JPEG or a PNG, and then I can slice it in Photoshop and use those images as background just for the reference of this tutorial. So over here, I'm at my Elementor website and I want to go to the backend to templates, theme builder. Then I go to the header and I want to create a new header. So I click on add new. I don't want to use one of those templates. So I click on the X. Now I want to start from scratch. I click on the plus. I want to go for the flexbox and I want to go for the arrow to the right, like this. Then I want to have a logo, a menu, and two other icons. So what I will do, I will go to the plus. I search for an image. I drag it over here. I click on the plus. I go for a menu, a WordPress menu. I drag it over here to the right. I want to click on the plus. I want to go for another image. I want to use an image as an icon. So I drag the image here at the right. Awesome. If I would click on publish, I can add a condition and that's that I want to show this on the entire website. So on every single page, I want to show this header. So I click on save and close. And now if I would go to the website, all in command, I go to the website. This is what we have so far. I think we can improve that a bit. So I will go over here. I click on the first image, I click on choose image, and that's the logo I fetched using SVG grabber. So I grab this one and it's a bit too big. So I'll make it smaller by going to the style and then the width in pixels. Let's see. Here at Apple, it's quite small. It's also here, let's do 40. Over here, this is, for the sake of the tutorial, I have another image. This is this one. Go to the style in pixels because I want to focus on the blurry background, not on creating all those icons. So let me make it something like that. It should be smaller. What happened over here? Okay, then I go to the menu, go to the style. I want to go for the text color and it is D9D9D9. Okay, I want to make it a bit smaller. So I go to the typography, size. Let's see. What I see when I make it smaller, this is going to the left. That's not what I want. So I go to the section or the container. You can also find it over here at the structure, the container. I can call this the menu. Then I go to the layout and the direction is okay, but I want the justification of the content to have space between. So this one is totally at the left. This one is totally at the right and this one is in between. And I also want to align them vertically or horizontally. Vertically, I guess, like this in the center. So everything will be in the center horizontally and vertically. That looks better. Now I can go back to the menu and I can make the size a bit bigger. So I think it's perfect. I can also make it smaller and then go to the horizontal padding and increase that. Publish. Then I can go to the site settings. I can go to the layout and I can change the width of the website if I want to do that, if I want to make it the same width as the website from Apple, but I'm okay with this. So what I can do for the reference, I can create a new area, new flexbox, arrow down, and I go for the style, normal background type, classic image. And I grab this image. I select it. Okay, I don't see that much, so I'll scroll down over here. I go to the display size and make it a cover. Then I go back to layout and I increase the minimum height. Now we start to see things. Great. Until it starts becoming bigger, this is what I want. Okay, publish. Then I go back to the heading. I go to advanced. Here at margin, I turn off that everything is linked, and then at the bottom, I want to decrease it. Like that. Let's do 70. Publish. Let's click on the eye so we can see how it looks. Okay. I don't see the logo. It's beneath this area. So what I will do over here at this container, the Z index at advanced, I say 10. So it's in front of everything else. Again, I go to the logo. Why is it getting bigger every time? Let's say 20 also here. Smaller. This can be 20 and then a bit bigger. Okay, let's see again how it looks now. It's not exactly the same, but let's not focus on the sizes this time. What I want to do, I want to make this background blurry. First, I want to make it sticky. How can I do that? I go back to Elementor. I go to the container. If I cannot grab this because there are multiple containers overlapping each other, I go to the site structure and I call this one temp. So we will delete this later. So I go to the menu. So the whole menu is now selected. Then here at advanced, I close layout. I go to motion effects and I want to turn on sticky. So now it sticks with us. But we can see through it. There's no style. So in order to fix that, we go to the Ferdy.com website. Hit enter. Then you need to search for Bloxy, because I also covered this in other tutorials. And you need to go to the Bloxy theme tutorial. If you click on that and you scroll down a bit, you see create a blurry backdrop with CSS code. So we only don't have to select all this stuff. So we need to select it from this character on, copy it. Now, what I will do. Here at menu, I go to advanced layout, and then at CSS classes, I call this one blurry. And here at custom CSS, I say dot blurry as a class. Let me see again, dot blurry. And then I paste this. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. If I click on publish, now if I scroll down, we can see through it. Well, a few things I see. This header is really big, so I go to advanced layout and I uncheck the padding, so it will be 0. So it's starting to look like what we see over here. I think this is more intense, way more intense, because if I go over the Pro here at Apple, here it's a lot lighter, so we can adjust all those settings. So I go back to the custom CSS. The background color, I can make it black by 0, 0, 0. This is red, green, blue, and opacity. So let's see how that will work. If I scroll down, it's a little bit less visible. So if I change the transparency to 0.9, you see less coming through. So I think you can play around with that until it's a little bit the same as over here. So how about 0.7 or 0.6 again, but now it's darker, so everything's fine. Okay. We can play around with the blurriness. Right now I have 30, if I would say 10, you still see it's called Pro, but if I would say 110, then it will be washed out, or I don't know if that's the right word, but really blurry. So you can play around with that. I let's say 20. So let's publish it. And I go to the website, scroll down, I can see through it. And then I want to get rid of the second area, the temp area, right mouse click, delete, publish. So also here you can see through it, even with this pink thing over here. So now, since I said it should be available on every area of the website, every single area, I go to this image, I go to content, I want to link it to a custom URL, which is the /, so it goes to the root of the domain. So now if I refresh this and I click over here, this is what we have created using Elementor Pro. This is what Apple has. I think we created something quite similar. So here at Apple, if I go to the bluish area, I think it looks beautiful. If I hover over this, let's do the same. You know what? Since we're here, let's make it look the same. So I go back to the header. I should rename the header. I can do that here at the settings. Call this one main header. Publish. I think it's still too big. So over here, style 18. Here, okay. And I want to go make the size smaller. So I go to the site settings. And I go to layout. I change it to 980. And I click, or I save it first. I click over here, go to the style. Smaller, and also over here, publish. So let's take a look. I go to the homepage. Only the app should be smaller, and then I think we have the same results. Again, oh, sorry, this is the. So if I'm here at the homepage, so not at the header, if you want to change that, click over here, go to the header. Or you say command E and say I want to work on the header, main header. We are already there. So that's also how you can search. So click over here. Let's do 15. Publish. Homepage. Well, I think we can be happy with the end result. And now we have something that a multi-billion dollar company website also has. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Feel free to subscribe for more upcoming tutorials. And by the way, feel free to like this video. And then I hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye.